Kenny's Hop Show.
Hey everybody, what's going on? It's Kenny Hop Show with the tailgate sessions today. Today the tailgate sessions are a little different. We're going to have the handlebar session because today's video is about change. Sometimes you just got to change things up. Sometimes you get in a rut. You get in a rut with your playing, you get a rut in your music, you get in a rut in life. Well, lately I was in a rut in my harmonica playing, you know. Yeah, that over and over again. You know, couldn't come up with anything new, couldn't play at the jams, I couldn't throw down, I just couldn't do it. I lost all my passion and I lost all my vigor to play. My heart just wasn't in it and it was horrible. First thing I did, I put the thing down. I put it down for about 2 weeks, I didn't pick it up, I hardly played a note, I didn't do anything. And believe it or not, that helped. I wasn't worried about it, I didn't think about it too much. You know, you can't put too much weight on this thing, you know. It's something we're supposed to enjoy and have fun with, and just something that we do. You know, we're not all touring musicians. I don't know very many of us that are making a paycheck on these things. This is something that we enjoy and that we enjoy doing, and everything that goes along with it: the harmonicas, the microphones, the amplifiers, the pedals, the cables, the cords, the wireless stuff. You know. Our cases, the things that we do. We all know what we're doing. We're all on hot players. We're all on harmonica effects. We're all on harp gear. We're all looking for that next great thing. You know, that amp you gotta have. That microphone that just kicks ass. You could check out Lash Call Microphones. We all know who's involved with that there. But anyway, about the rut we gotta get out of. To me, a rut is nothing but a distraction and a lack of inspiration. If we're distracted or if we're not inspired, we're just not going to play that great. And we got to get our mind out of that phase. We can't sulk about it. We have to change our attitude. You know, we can't be burying our faces in our hands and go, "Oh, we can't play. We can't play. Well. You got to snap yourself out of that attitude. And like I said, putting the thing down, that don't hurt. You got to feed your brain. You can't play in 2 weeks or so, in 2 days or 2 hours that you put it down. Watch a documentary about harmonica playing. If you can, try to watch Pocket Full of Soul or The History of the Tin Sandwich. The Tin Sandwich you can find on YouTube. Pocket Full of Soul, I think you got to buy. It was recently on there for free, but if you missed it, you missed it. Great movie, great video. All the greats are in there. Joe Fisco, Rod Piazza, Benjamin Ritchie, this guy, that guy, the other guy. Everybody was in there. Great movie. Catch it if you can. But anyway, back to getting out of our rut. Like I said, feed the brain. Read a book. Watch a movie. Watch a lesson. Give a lesson. Even if you don't think you're at the point where you can give a lesson, you can show somebody something. And when you go right back to basics, you learn some stuff. You know, the simple things that you're way past that you don't even have to deal with anymore. Sometimes revisiting those will open up new thoughts and new pathways in your brain. You know, teaching somebody the old "I'm a Man" riff. You know, we all know that. But you know, sometimes you might be able to change it up and make a new riff. You know, try something. Teach somebody something, and you'll learn something yourself. Another thing that you might be able to do, go to a different jam. I know around me, probably the same thing around you, wherever you are in the world, there's a good jam and there's a crappy jam. You always go to the good jam. Do yourself a favor, visit the crappy jam. I know it's not run right, I know it doesn't have the same caliber of players that you're used to playing with, but hell, go to the crappy jam and you can rule the roost. Usually the crappy jam leans a little bit towards top 40 or rock and roll. It's not our blues jam. It's not the 1-4-5 blues all night long. It leans to classic rock, and it is what it is. But go there, play some classic rock, or go to the coffee house jam and play some singer-songwriter stuff. You know, change it up. Something different. Keep doing the same stuff over and over again. We're never going to learn anything. So go to that not so spectacular jam that's in your town that we all have. Go try it out. Do something different. Another thing you might try, find another hot player at the crappy jam that you never go to, because there's a hot player there. Find somebody new to have a little bullshit session with, you know. I know every time I meet a new hot player, I introduce myself, we talk a little shop, we go back and forth, and, you know, even if you get nothing out of it, you might have a new friend, or you might have something in common, or something you can use. I got my notes here, because I can't remember nothing. Referring to my notes, try a new instrument. I ain't saying you're going to go pick out a guitar, or a saxophone, or drums. Go buy a recorder. Just the different breath motions and the different things that you do with your hands and the different notes that you're going to get. Get a couple of ditties out on a recorder and then you put them in your brain into the harmonica. It's some melodies you never thought of, something you'd never even think of trying. You don't even have to get good on that recorder. You know, play it for a couple of days, you know, three blind mice or something. That's what I did, you know. Figure out three blind mice, you know, just something different to fuel your brain, because that's all that being in a rut is. You're bored. You got the new instrument, or if you don't want to get a new instrument, go buy an effects pedal. Go buy a flanger. Go buy an Ottawa. Go buy a distortion pedal. It's gonna sound horrible for harmonica, but I don't know. You might find something that's good for harmonica too. I love to try new pedals. It's the one and sole reason I ever walk into Guitar Center. I go into the used section. If there's a pedal under $20, more times than not, I'll buy it just to try it on harmonica. Out of the 10 pedals that I bought, there's one that was somewhat decent for harmonica. But they're fun. You goof around with them for a couple of days, and you learn new things, and you try new things. Like I keep saying, all about trying new things, all about not getting bored. But Digitech Def Metal Distortion Pedal for your harmonica? No, it sucks. You're never gonna play it out. But you know what? At home, you'll do all sorts of stupid things with it, and you'll have fun with it, and you'll be playing differently. And all those different things that you play will come back to you when you go back to the blues. After you get done with your pedal, or if you don't want to try your pedal, go to your computer and type in basic musical theory. Read a few paragraphs. I don't know much theory at all, or probably this much, but you know, even if you retain just one small snippet of it, that's more music in your brain and more that can transfer to your harmonica to get you out of your rut. All about change, new things, different things. And if you still can't get out of it, practice. Make yourself a practice promise. Whatever you can do for the day, 5 minutes, 10 minutes. I'm not saying you gotta go play for 4 hours every day. Practice while you drive back and forth to work. Nobody's there to see you, and it's a great thing to do. You can mess up. You only need one key, and it's all good. But promise to yourself that you'll practice for 5 or 10 minutes a day, even if you're a terrific harp player. You know, it doesn't hurt. Maybe you'll learn a new riff. Maybe you'll get down a riff. You know, there's a few riffs that I know, but I don't have them down. I can't play backwards and forward, upside down and sideways like we all should be able to. But that also helps you get out of your rut. Once you got something in your pocket, it stays there. You know it. You'll never forget it. You know, I'm a man riff. We all got that down. Every single one of us got it down. But if we didn't practice it, we'd never get it. So make yourself a practice promise. We've been through theory. I was going to say try busking, but that kind of puts you on the spot. If you can get away with it, try it, because you're on the spot. You got your hat out there, and you're in a quiet place, and, you know, make some noise, you know. If you make a little money, that don't hurt. But while you're out there playing for the public and you're not in a jam session, you are forced to come up with stuff. You are forced to learn. You are forced to play the music, because you can't lay back and let the guitar player have the lead. It's only you. You have to keep playing it. So give that a shot. Even if you've never done it before, go down to your local haunt where there's something going on, or even if it's a popular spot for people to walk, or a festival or something, or if you find a little corner, take one out, put your hat down, see what happens. All sorts of other things. A couple other things. you could do to get out of your rut. Try giving a lesson. Everyone can teach somebody something. You know, if you're teaching somebody the very basics, you'll revisit the basics and you can expand on what you already know. One other thing that I've done, that I've tried, my amp, my basin, we all heard about the basin. It's dialed in a certain way, the way I like it. Take all your knobs, click them all to zero, close your eyes, and dial that thing in blind. Just play in the mic, do what you can, and just turn those knobs until you get it right in your ear, not by what you say. You know, because, you know, my setting is presence on 8, mid dimed, bass dimed, treble rolled all the way back, channel 1 volume on 2, channel 2 volume on 3, and that's how I play. Well, now I got the Hot Man pedal, that's got a couple of more secret settings in there, but, and I've been able to expand on all the settings on the amp because of that pedal. Wonderful pedal, go buy it, go see Rick Davis, by the way, buy that pedal at Memphis Minis. Beautiful pedal. We're not even gonna get into playing into this. This is just a video to get out of your rut. Well, like I said before, buy a new pedal. I bought that Hartman pedal, and I've been messing with it. I probably played for two, three hours a day every day since I got that pedal. And it's a great thing just to get you. Even if I wasn't in the slump, you get a new toy, you play with it, and you keep playing and you keep playing and you keep playing. Before you know it, you're out of your rut. Let's see, I talked about my distraction, I talked about thinking outside of the box, I've talked about feed your brain, this, that, and the other thing. And that's all the rambling I got for you today. Tailgate sessions coming from the handlebars today. Get out of your rut. Now shut this video off, go grab a harmonica, and go play something. Till next time, it's Kenny Hop Show. Bye-bye.